Mr. President, how was your first full day back, sir?
Fine.
Not too much for you? Not too much work?
Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much. I don't think I can do that for every state dinner, but. Well, good evening and welcome to the White House. Tonight, it's my pleasure to return the hospitality that was extended to us by President Lee during our visit to China. And I'm grateful to have had the opportunity to develop a personal relationship with him. And it's my honor, President Lee, to greet you affectionately as Lao Peng Yo. Now, for most of those of you who don't speak Chinese, that means old friend. Today, when President Lee and I renewed our friendship, he expressed his wishes for my full recovery. In fact, he told me that once I was totally back on my feet, a young man like myself could expect him to have a long and distinguished career ahead of him. Well, President Lee comes from a nation whose people are known for their traditional respect for the elders. President Lee, I can assure you I'm doing my best to reestablish that tradition in our own country. But I learned about that and many other wonderful aspects of China during our visit last year. Although our stay was brief, I did as the Chinese say, look at the flowers while riding horseback, capturing lasting impressions not only of the magnificence of the culture and the land, but also the bold vision of those directing China's future. The progress we've made is a tribute to individuals with courage and foresight, like President Lee, on both sides of the Pacific. The relationship we've built improves the material well-being and increases the security of our countries. Areas of disagreement exist. These should not be ignored, nor should they be permitted to inhibit us from acting together in these many areas of commonality. Historic truths determine our fundamental national interests, and they continue to draw our two peoples together. After our meeting today, I'm happy to say I remain confident that Chinese-American cooperation will grow and strengthen in the years ahead. Underscoring the momentum of our relationship, I'm delighted tonight to announce that the Chinese government has invited Vice President Bush to China and that he has accepted this most gracious invitation. And such visits as yours, Mr. President, elevate the relationship of the leaders of our two nations, enhance our joint efforts, and open new doors of cooperation. President Lee, by the time you return home, you will have seen much of the United States and met many Americans in and out of government. You will have seen our industry, our people, and our land. We Americans came here from almost every nation, including China, to an undeveloped land, a wilderness. We're proud of what we've accomplished. And today, we're proud to stand beside the people of China who are striving to build a better life. By working together, we can and will create a more prosperous and peaceful world. So, let us drink a toast to that and to President Lee and Madam Lane, his wife.
宋东先生和李根夫人，女士们、先生们，今天晚上承蒙宋东先生和李根夫人为我和我的夫人举行隆重国宴，感到非常荣幸。今日中我代表我的夫人、我的同事以及我个人的名义，向宋东先生和李根夫人表示 衷心的感谢发展中美关系是我们两国人民的共同愿望。两国政府发表的三个公报，确定了指导两国关系的重要原则。我希望中美之间的主要分歧及台湾问题能够按照中美两国政府历次公报的精神和各自承担的义务加以改转， 以便两国摆脱这一问题的羁绊，集中精力去开辟中美友好合作的新天地。当今世界上重大最迫切的问题是和平与发展，我认为应该充分尊重各国独立和主权的基础上发展国际合作，促进共同繁荣，维护世界和平。 中国正在转型聚焦的进行建设，我们需要一个长期的国际和平环境。中国坚决奉行独立自主的和平外交政策和实行对外开放政策。我们愿意在和平共处五项原则的基础上，同一切国家发展友好关系。我们谋求中美关系持久、稳定的发展。 我们也希望美国和苏联、西欧和东欧改善关系，希望世界的局势走向和谐。中国是发展中的国家，我们支持第三世界各国的谋求经济的发展、社会进步和改善国际地位的努力。我们愿意看到南北关系的改善，也积极支持第三世界国家和南南合作的立场，维护世界和平，谋求共同繁荣，关系到 世界的前途和人类的命运，我们认为中国和美国都可以，而且应该为这一崇高目标做出努力。 做出自己的贡献。现在我提议为中美关系的发展和两国人民的幸福，为世界和平，为里根总统和夫人的健康，为在座的女士们、先生们的健康，干杯！